Okay, I got that fire started. I put three of those cotton balls that have petroleum jelly / Vaseline, for those who don't realize that Vaseline and petroleum jelly are the same thing. And I just started throwing a bunch of branches on there. About half as long as those right there. You can see them down in the wood, in the fire. It's gonna burn pretty quick. I got some over there. Let's see if I can zoom in, just where they're at. Right there, you see all those right there? Ask my wife to bring out the axe down here, because I'm gonna bring them over here. It's like this big one here, we cut with it. That's real big. That's for an all-nighter fire that you want it to burn slow and long. These are all different types of oak. Right now it is 7:26 p.m. July. We just said it. July 23rd, 2016. And I'm just sitting out here with this fire. We're going to cook maybe a couple hot dogs out here and maybe some marshmallows. Put my cane down here. God, I can't even get my cane down. But, you know, I dug it down. I went on an angle, you know, I made like a curvature bottom. I want to do bigger, deeper than that actually yet. I want to get at least four more of those, I'd call them triangle type stones there. They're for gardens. I get four more of those at least. And I don't know, that might be high enough. If I take those back away from that opening and use a either a shovel or a hoe or something to break it up. But I want to go down a little bit deeper, about 4 inches deeper. About as deep as one of those cinder blocks, those little, not cinder blocks, but those stones right there, that's about 4 to 5 inches. So I want to go about that deep down yet. Then we have this fire out here. And I might make it into like a Dakota stove where you put it over, you go underneath, you make a hole over here and join it. And that keeps the fire down so people really can't see it and you can cook on it or whatever. So, oh, you didn't put the safety thing on it? Okay. Oh, thank you. Ax me about it and I'll tell you. See, I should run for the government. I said ax. Just ax me something. And I don't want to be politically correct, because if you are, you're not for the government. Not the one that's in there now. Yeah. That's my little stirring rods here. I'm going to cut those in half with that ax and put them in there as this gets lower. And like I said, I'll get one more load on that broken dolly, flat tires on it. That's why I want to get some hard tires, but they're flat tires. We'll get a bunch more over there and bring it over here, and then we'll be cooking before it gets too dark. You know? Yeah, it's almost 7:30 now. So, I'm waiting for the drones to be out here. Usually, when we come out here, right over here, you'll see a drone up in the sky, right? Anywhere from right there to about there. And it'll bounce around back and forth and all this. And like I said, my wife and I stand up and give it the finger like this, and all of a sudden you'll see it turn, and it'll turn south and just start going down that way. You can hear it as it goes by, like a lawnmower up in the sky. So that's the chemtrails up in the sky there. It looks like rain laced clouds with chemtrails. So technically, this right here would help clear off that crap. Oh yeah, I can feel the heat from that thing. That's why I was saying on here, I want to dig it down about 4 inches deep. About as thick as one of those small triangle type bricks, deep down like that. And then, you know, to me that would help with the wind, because right now you see the wind, that's hot right now. It's already burning fast. For that to be oak, I didn't think it would burn that fast. Mm-hmm. Over on either Highway 79 or Tinsley. Probably Highway 79.
Last time I heard a bunch of coyotes, so yeah. They don't come around here.
No, they won't come over here by the fire. Alright, so that's how you get your fire started. Like I said, cotton balls with petroleum jelly, aka Vaseline to some people. wrap them. I just get messy. I don't care. A lot of people don't. They want their hands messy. I just get a gob of it in my hand. I just mash it around the cotton ball. I smash it around. Just push them down. Put them in a Ziploc bag and then put it inside another waterproof, semi-waterproof container. Fire starter. Can't have enough of anything. Everything's redundancy. Always have at least three of everything you need. And you won't ever be looking for it. But I got all kinds of wood I'm going to use here. So that's how to get a fire started. I mean, it just took me about 10 strikes total. Well, I'm wearing that. But maybe, even if it was 20 strikes, it told me we just to strike it onto that, get sparks onto the cotton ball with the propane jelly on it, i.e. Vaseline. And it just lights, and it'll last for about 5 or 10 minutes. You just put little branches on there and get started. So, there you go, simple.